Marley? Jacob Marley?
Scrooge.
Vision, your hallucination, probably brought on by an undigested bit of beef or a blob of mustard. Yes, that's what you are. You're a blob of mustard.
I tell you, Scrooge, there is more of the grave than a gravy about me.
You do not exist, Jacob Marley. Humbug, I tell you. Humbug.
Humbug, eh? Now, do you believe me?
Absolutely. Oh, I thank you for your visit and for your counseling. And now, good sir, I bid you a fond farewell. Why do you walk the earth? And why do you come to me?
I am doomed to wander the world and bear this what I cannot share, but might have shared on earth. I wear the chain that I forged in life on earth. I made it link by link and yard by yard. And now I will never be rid of it any more than you will ever be rid of yours.
Mine?
In
imagine the weight and length of the mighty chain you are making, Scrooge?
It was as long and as heavy as this one 7 Christmases ago,
and you have labored at it mightily ever since. It is a great and ponderous chain you are making, Scrooge.
Jacob, Ward, Jacob Marley, speak comfort to me.
I have none to give. Very little is permitted of me. I cannot rest. I cannot stay. I cannot linger anywhere. In life, my spirit, like yours, never wandered far beyond the reach of our narrow counting house.
But you were always a good man of business, Jacob.
Mankind is our business, but how seldom do we attend to it! I know this because I have sat invisible at your elbow many and many a day in your office.
My office? Watching me?
Hear me, Scrooge. My time is almost gone. I am here tonight to warn you. It is your only hope.
No, Jacob!
Phantoms in the sky, oh.